In today's video, we're going to talk about the process of setting up a contract within the Klevr Contracts application. As you can see on the screen, we have navigated to the contracts sub area, and we have a couple contracts in the system. Two of them have already been made active, and today we'll work on the draft contract record. I'll select the draft contract, and we can see we're now open the change management for dispute resolution system uplift contract. And here we can see the contract form. Within the contract section, we can add things like a code, the name of the contract, and then the beneficiaries or different accounts and contacts associated with this contract. We can also enter a description of the contract, an external reference if this record is going to be integrated to other systems, and then we can tag the contract for easy search and reporting capabilities. In the middle, we have our finance section, which will give us the financials of the contract. It also gives us an area to upload the official contract document once that has been completed. And then we have our categorization section, where we can enter things like the contract type. Here we can see we're currently looking at a subcontract. And then we can have things like the contract group this contract is associated with, a primary contract. If it is a subcontract, it should have a primary contract associated. Whether or not this is an all of government contract, the procurement type, and then an originating opportunity if this contract was generated by an application for funds. On the right side, we have our key date, so our start and end date. We have our key stakeholders, where we can have multiple stakeholders, such as a contract manager or responsible manager. This can be used to automatically send notifications or raise and assign tasks to those users associated with this contract. And then we have a department that this contract will belong to. Lastly, on the summary tab, we have our integration details, where we can see whether or not this contract record has been integrated to a downstream system and the date and time of that integration attempt. If I select the financials tab, here we can set up the different contract budgets associated with this contract. Here you can see that we only have the one budget allocation for the full amount, so this one contract has one contract budget. However, oftentimes a contract might have multiple contract budgets that will utilize the entire contract amount. On the left, we can see some calculated fields. So we have our overall contract amount value, and then we have our annual amount value that will be calculated based off of the start and end dates for this contract. And then we can see the total unallocated amounts. This will calculate based off of the contract amount and all of the amounts of all of the different budget allocations. In this instance, we have a total contract amount of 100,000, and we have the one budget allocations that is going to utilize that entire 100,000 amount. Next, we have our total transaction amount, which will automatically calculate as transaction records are added to this contract. We have our write back amount, and the total paid amount can be tracked here. Dropping down into the subgrid, we can see all of the transaction records associated with this contract. At the moment, there are none, but as contract transaction records are created and then paid, we'll be able to track that within this list here. Navigating to the terms tab, I can start to enter my terms for the contract. So I can set up my payment terms as long as any commentary that I want associated with that payment term information. I have my renewal area, where I can set up a renewal date, a renewal period, the right of renewal, and whether or not this contract will automatically roll over. And then at time of renewal, if I want, I can enter a renewal reason and some renewal information. The termination period typically is blank by default. However, if a contract is activated and then ended early or terminated before its intended end date, then it will allow me to enter the actual terminated date. It won't currently defaults to the normal end date of the contract. It will give me a termination notice, so if that can be set up as part of the terms on the contract, and then I can enter some termination notes at time of contract end. The Terms and Conditions tab will allow me to build a library of T's and C's, and then when I'm setting up a contract, I can automatically apply terms and conditions from my existing library to that contract, which saves me from having to rewrite a lot of those T's and C's. I can just have that library, and then I can drag and drop those into the contract to make sure that they're captured alongside that contract record. It's very important when setting up contracts that milestones are set up. So I can navigate to the milestones tab, and and I can select new milestone, and this will allow me to set up milestones that must be completed in order for this contract to be satisfied. Now within milestones, you can have milestone objectives. So a milestone might require multiple objectives, and milestones also can be tracked to transaction records that we looked at before, which means that a milestone must be submitted and approved before the funds on that transaction will be released to the recipient based off of their milestone completion. We have contract revisions. Once a contract has been activated, you can do contract variations, and you can track old contracts in this tab here, where you can see historical contracts that were set up, and then you will be able to quickly see the changes and dates of those changes as a contract exists within the system. And then we have some approvals that can be configured and tracked within the system. And if you do have an external stakeholder portal, then we can see some portal information, like whether or not this has been published to that portal. Once I've entered all of the information that I want to enter for my contract, I could then share this with someone else, or I can activate that contract to get started. Thank you very much.